Hey guys, it's Maggie. You may notice that I'm in a different place recording and I don't have much of a setup. I'm sitting on the floor and also kind of look like crap today, but that's okay. I wanted to make a video for you guys. I was actually tagged by Sacred Earth Warrior, and I think the original tag came from Madame Luna, and it is a pagan first tag, so I thought it'd be kind of nice just to get to know you kind of thing, and give me a good reason to do a video for you guys. So the first question is, what was your first encounter with paganism? And for me, we could go all the way back to Sleeping Beauty. That was my favorite movie when I was growing up. I really loved Maleficent, and then she was my favorite character because, you know, I like that she had magic and stuff like that. And I also saw Hocus Pocus in theaters when it came out, and I really loved the witches. Like, I always wanted to be a witch and like ride broomsticks and that kind of thing. Then not long after that, the movie The Craft came out, and that's when I realized that this was kind of a real thing and that I would be able, you know, to actually be a witch and practice witchcraft if I really wanted to. And I was really scary at the time, but also incredibly exciting. The next question is, what was your first witch book? One of the first witch books I ever got like my hands on was the book Celtic Magic by DJ Conway. And not a very great beginner book, I can say. I didn't have it for long before I'm making my own purchases. And me and one of my friends would sneak into the bookstore at the mall and buy these witchy books and hide them from our parents and stuff like that. I did own a lot of like Silver Ravenwolf books and all that kind of stuff when I was young. I did really enjoy Teen Witch by Silver Ravenwolf. That was one of my favorites back then. And you know, a lot of people super hate on that kind of stuff, but you know, when you're really young and kind of getting into it, I think sometimes some of the lighter side of things is kind of the better way to go. What was your first spell? I honestly can't remember what my first spell is. I know when I was young, we would always have like seances and stuff like that for fun, which is kind of weird. And we would use the Ouija board. My mom was totally fine with this. Like, my parents didn't really care. They, you know, they thought we were just kind of messing around and everything, but Tess was very serious. I guess in that way, like contacting the spirits, that kind of was my first spell in a way. And like I said, like first formal spell, I don't really recall what that would be. It's been a very long time because I've been practicing basically since I was like 10 or 11. So it's hard for me to remember some of this stuff. What was your first crystal or stone? I believe it was actually an amethyst. We have this little craft fair that comes into town sometimes, and one of the times there were these people that were selling these stones with like little pewter images on them, and I got this like tiny cluster of amethyst that had a little unicorn on it, and I wish I knew what happened to it. I don't know where it is or what really happened to it. But that was the first stone I ever recall owning. And we always have, I live in the South, so we have a lot of those places where you can go and like mine for gemstones and stuff. So I always had a lot of stones, like just really rough crystal, like quartz and stuff like that, from those kinds of places. The next question is, what was your first god or goddess? Well, like I told you guys before, I started out with some, you know, very basic, kind of Wiccan books. And so my first god or goddess was kind of the Wiccan, like, lord and lady. And I still kind of enjoy that archetype today of just the very, like, basic, primitive, feminine and masculine energy like that. And those are some archetypes that I still in some ways still work with a lot. Now, as far as like my first name goddess, the big one that I worked with in the beginning was the goddess the Morrigan, and I worked with her a long time during high school. And I still do have a fondness for her, but I don't really connect with her anymore the way that I used to. I'm sorry, my animals are going nuts. So I'm sitting on the floor, so they don't think they need to be over here. What was the first place you ever encountered other pagans is the next question. I suppose I did have some friends that were also interested in the craft, but not counting them, it would have to be a pagan pride festival that I went to when I was, I probably was 15 or 16 or something like that. My first, well, and that kind of comes into the next question is, what was my first festival? And it was that Pagan Pride Day. And it was actually the best one that I've been to since, like, I'm trying to go to a few others, but they weren't really as good or as organized as that one was. So I don't really live in an area that's very close to where a lot of festivals happen, so I don't really get a good chance to go to a whole lot of festivals or anything. What's your first class or workshop? I've never formally taken a class or workshop. I did take do some online study for a little bit a couple of years ago, but that's really all the formal training I ever had. I'm very self-taught, and I think I made a video about that in the past. And so all of my training comes from trial and error and lots and lots and lots of study over time. What was your first chant? This is kind of funny because my first chant was the chant that was from the movie The Craft, the Earth, Air, Fire, Water chant, and I still really enjoy that. I'm not very big into chanting, which I wish I was, but I get kind of shy during ritual, and so a lot of things that I do don't involve a lot of like chanting or spoken word even. It's more of a silent, meditative type of thing that I go through when I'm doing rituals, so I don't get big into a whole lot of like chanting. I am trying to get more into like drumming, but I kind of suck at it too, so that's something I have to work on. The first divination that you learned. The first divination that I learned was I actually bought a deck of tarot cards when I was 11 or 12, I think. My mom let me buy them. And it was the Tarot of Shadow and Light, I believe is the name of it. It was the Light and Shadow Tarot is the name of it. And I don't have the original deck with me anymore that I bought, but I did have a very good friend of mine bought it for me again because I hadn't told her that. It was such a cool deck. It's all in black and white. It has some really awesome images, and it's fairly close to the Rider-Waite style deck, but the cards are they're kind of large, and it's kind of hard for me to work with them because I have very small hands. And so it's something I do enjoy looking at them occasionally and, you know, remembering that fondness that I had when I was a kid trying to learn them, but it's not something I really work with a whole lot anymore. My first tool was actually, apart from my tarot cards, is probably an athame that I bought, and it's really more like a paper opener, and I still have it actually to this day. I'll have to show it to you guys one day. It's just a little athame, and I also bought a mortar and pestle. That was one of my other first tools that I got, because you know what's cooler than an athame and mortar and pestle? Like, to me, that's ultimate. I eventually moved on to like cauldrons and all that kind of stuff, and wands and everything, but those are still some of my favorite tools that I like to use. What was your first method of energy work? Some of the first stuff that I remember doing as far as energy work is, you know, very basic grounding and centering kind of energy work. And oftentimes I still do the same thing that I've always done as far as if I am casting a circle or something like that. I like to spread the circle out from within myself, and I also use that as a form of like shielding and everything else. And so I've always been very big into pretty much shielding, basically, but that is something that I learned very early on, one of the first things that I ever really started doing as far as energy work goes. What was your most memorable first experience? One of the most memorable first experiences that I have is when I sort of did a dedication to my path. And I remember being young and I was living here in this house, and it wasn't anything really formal because I didn't really know what I was doing, but I just kind of went outside and spent some time outside and just, you know, spoke to my gods and goddesses and, you know, made that commitment to honor them and be with them and that kind of thing. And I remember it must have been during springtime because we have camellia trees here, and I remember them being in bloom because I sat near one while I was doing this. So they only bloom kind of twice a year, in the winter time and then again in the springtime. So it had to have been close to that time whenever it happened. And that's all for the questions. I tag anyone who wants to do this video. I certainly enjoyed it. I certainly enjoyed trying to think back to all those first times because I'm 28 now, and like I said, a lot of stuff happened, you know, between the ages of like 10 and 13 for me, so it's been a little while ago. But yeah, I hope you all enjoyed this video. I do encourage anyone who wants to do it to give it a try. And thank you again for tagging me in this to do this. And I love you guys so much, and I'll talk to you later. Stay weird.